Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss the scope of variable in functions. Variable is a label for a location in memory which is used to hold a value. In Python, the same variable may be reused to store values of any type. Say here given an example where initially a holds the value 5, so the data type of variable a is integer. Later, the A holds the value something. Now, when you try to print its data type, it will show it as string. When you change the value of variable A to 2.5, then the data type will be changed to float. This is the flexibility we enjoy with Python. Now, what do you mean by scope of a variable? The part of code where the variable value is visible, or in other ways, it is accessible, you call it as scope of that particular variable. With this introduction, we will see how the variable scope plays an important role in your functions. To explain it, we have taken a function f. The function logic is, it takes an argument and then increment its value by 1, print that value, and then again send back that value to the caller function. This is the caller function and this is the called function. Now we will first look at the caller function, or in other words the main program code. Here I have initialized a variable x with the value 3, then made a function call to f of x and assigned the return value of function to the variable z. So the argument list given in the function call, you call it as actual parameter. This argument list can be either variable, like here given as x, or it can be a value. You can directly even pass 3. And what is formal parameter? The argument list present in function definition, you call it as formal parameter, and always it has to be a variable. There is no possibility of having values in function definition. Okay, so what happens, what is this global scope and function scope? Throughout the program, you can have access to your function code, the variable value x and the variable value of z. So when we start with the program, for the function you have some code, and for x you have assigned some value, and for z you have not assigned any value. It need to be assigned only after invoking this function call. So this is the initial stage and the function scope. Within the function, the value of the variable which can be accessed only within the function is x, because I have only one variable declared, that is x. See, this x is completely different from this x. It has global scope, it is declared in main, and this has only function scope. So lifetime exists only within the function, right? Now what happens when I invoke the function f of x? It will go for the function, and in the function statement I have incremented the value by 1. So now the x value will become 4. See, here I have incremented the value by 1. So the 3 will now change to 4. Right? Then I have printed the value as 4. Then I have to return this variable value x back. So when you return it, you will have the value as, when you return this value, the value will be copied back to the variable z. So now in the global scope, you have some memory for the function f. Then you have access for variable x with the value 3 and variable z with the value 4. But once the scope, once the call has been returned from the function, your function scope ends, even its lifetime becomes dead. So what you are understanding is, the value of x is first copied from the called function to the caller function, In the caller function, you have a local copy of x and modification is done on that copy. But this modification is not reflected in the called function. The return value can be used by the caller. Right? Okay. Now, based on how the function retains the original value, you can classify the function as called by value and called by referencer. If the called function is capable of modifying the original value, then you call it as called by referencer. If the called function is not capable of modifying the original value, then you call it as called by value. In the example, what we have seen, it is of called by value type because the original value is not being modified. Only a copy is made and there the modification has been done. So it is an example of called by value. And in general, by default, the Python follows called by value. And called by reference is used for mutable objects like list, set and dictionary. When you pass list, set and dictionary as argument, you can enjoy the benefit of called by reference. Thank you.